In this presentation, our main emphasis would be on surgical segments of the liver. The liver is divided into several segments, just like the lung, where the segments are known as bronchopulmonary segments. Surgical segments of the liver. Surgical segments of the liver are also known as hepatic segments of the liver. Just like in the lung, you got bronchopulmonary segments. In the liver, also you got 8 segments. And each segment is independent, having its own blood supply, having its own hepatic artery, branch of the hepatic artery, a branch of the caudal vein, and a drainage system of independent biliary duct. So each segment is like a liver itself, and you can resect a part of the liver and give it to the another donor. So one liver can be donated to several donors. That's the importance of segments of the liver. Now, how are the segments formed? Now, for segmental division, the liver is divided into 3 parts. One is the caudate lobe. Now, the caudate lobe is number one lobe of the liver, and this is situated behind, as we have seen previously, between the inferior vena cava and ligamentum minosum. This caudate lobe has got independent supply of the biliary plus portal plus hepatic artery. So that is an independent lobe. Then we have got a right liver and left liver. What divides the right liver and left liver? It's an imaginary line. This is the gallbladder fossa over here. Anteriorly, gallbladder fossa, and posteriorly you got inferior vena cava. Inferior vena cava. So there is a dividing imaginary line, and this line is known as Cantilli line. This is an imaginary line from fundus of the gallbladder to the inferior vena cava. Fundus of the gallbladder to the inferior vena cava. This is known as Cantilli line or Cantilli line. And when you open this imaginary line, it has got middle hepatic vein. Middle hepatic vein. Falciform ligament is over here. Ligamentum teres is over here. Falciform ligament is over here. On the right side of the Cantilli line or middle hepatic vein. Now this is right liver and this is left liver. And the caudate lobe, which we spoke earlier on, is on the right side, not on the left side. Caudate lobe is in the right liver. So this is an imaginary line containing the middle hepatic vein, dividing the liver into right and left. Then there are two main other lines. Left liver is divided into two by another line which is coming over here. And this contains the right hepatic vein. This contains the right hepatic. The left liver is again divided by into two halves by another imaginary line, and this contains the left hepatic vein. This contains the right hepatic vein. And this is the middle vein, middle hepatic vein. They are arising from the inferior vena cava. They all drain into the inferior vena cava. Middle hepatic vein is scantily lined, or main portal fissure. This is the main portal fissure, dividing the liver into right and left. The right is further divided by right hepatic vein. Into median, this would be median, and this would be lateral. Similarly, over here, this is left hepatic vein dividing into median and left. So the three veins, middle hepatic, right hepatic vein, left hepatic vein, divides the liver into four lobes. 1, 2, 3, 4 lobes. And then there is a transverse hepatic plane at the level of the horizontal parts of the right and left branches of portal thyroid. There is a horizontal. The level of the bifurcation of the right and left, and they divide into four subdivisions, four over here and three over here plus one, so there are eight segments. So this is introduction to the segments of the liver. Now here you see the main portal fissure. This is the hepatic vein and this is the middle hepatic vein. Middle hepatic vein. Dividing into further draining into right hepatic vein and left hepatic vein. So this is known as cantile line. Starting from the gallbladder fossa, going up to the inferior vena cava. That's the left liver, this is the right liver. And the falciform ligament is on the left side. This is what we quadrate. So the quadrate lobe is a part of the left lobe of the liver. And this is portal thyroid. This is horizontal division of the bile duct of the portal vein, which runs transversely and divides them into further subdivisions of the lobes. Now this is another picture. You can see over here inferior vena cava over here and gallbladder fossa over here. This is the imaginary line. That's the left, this is the right, and this is falciform ligament. This is on the visceral surface, gallbladder fossa, anterior aspect, posterior aspect, and this is the line. That's the left, right. This is caudate and this is caudate. Caudate is independent. So is sometimes doubled as the third liver because it has got its own independent blood supply, drainage, it drains directly into the inferior vena cava. So this is well behind, posteriorly, and it's labeled sometimes the third limb. This diagram shows some segments of the liver, segmental division of the liver, and let's start this. This is the superior aspect and this is the inferior aspect, and this is the imaginary line from the gallbladder fossa running up to the inferior vena cava. And this has got middle hepatic vein running through it. So this is left liver on the left side of the middle hepatic vein, and this is right liver on the right side of the middle hepatic vein. The segment between the gallbladder and falciform ligament, this is falciform ligament. This is segment number 4. This is quadrate bone. Quadrate. Number 2, these are lateral segments. This was medial, these are lateral segments. So, two lateral segments, one is superior and one other, number 3 is inferior. So, this is left lateral superior and this is left lateral inferior. Now we come to the right side. These are anterior segments. This is right anterior inferior and this one is right anterior superior. So this is right anterior superior, this is right anterior inferior segments. Both are anterior. The posterior segments are not seen over here. Now this diagram shows the liver flattened X Y position. And you see some more segments. You see the segments which were not seen previously. That is the segments which are on the posterior aspect and more laterally. That is 6 and 7. Again, this is superior, this is inferior. And this is the imaginary line, which contains the middle hepatic vein. Middle hepatic vein. So let's start with the number 1 was caudate lobe. This is number 2, left lateral superior. This is number 3, left lateral inferior. This is caudate lobe. Then we come to the right side. These two are anterior segments and these two are posterior segments. So this is right anterior inferior, this is right anterior superior, and these are posterior segments which have not become visible, and this is right posterior inferior and this is right posterior superior. So this completes the segmental divisions seen on a flattened liver after the liver has been taken out of the human body.